You've checked and you know that your computer can be upgraded to Windows 11. But depending on the age of your computer, is that going to be the right decision? So let's talk about that in today's video. Hi, I'm Michelle, a computer coach, here sharing tips and tricks on your everyday software to help make life that little bit easier. Depending on what type of device you're using and the age of it, you might want to think about actually upgrading to Windows 11 on it. If you have got a, shall we say, slightly older machine, before you actually do upgrade to Windows 11, a couple of things to consider. First off, it needs very specific hardware. And if, yes, your machine has it, but if it's only just upgradable, what impact is that going to have on you working? It could be that the hardware can just about handle it, and that's not what we really want. That will have an impact on the overall speed of your machine, how long it takes to do something, and then every time you ask it to actually perform a command, process an action, are you going to be sitting there waiting for it to complete? Thing to consider is just because you can upgrade to Windows 11 doesn't automatically mean that you should. Couple of scenarios to help you make sense of whether you should be considering upgrading or actually just replacing it. So let's start with scenario one, when upgrading your computer makes sense. First thing to note is this is talking about a desktop PC. Desktops are much easier to upgrade to replace the physical hardware. A laptop, some of it can be, but most often it's not something you can easily do. So, if you have a mid-range desktop, 3 to 4 years old, maybe it doesn't quite make it. It's only got 8 gig of RAM, but it can be upgraded to 16 gig. It's got a processor that will handle Windows. It's got the minimum or close to it. The motherboard has this TPM header, so it does match the hardware requirement. Power supply is good, and you've got an HDD, so that's a hard disk drive, as your main storage option. This would need to be upgraded, and for that, you'd have to add the TPM 2.0 module. You can see approximate prices there. You'd need to upgrade the RAM, double it to 16 gig. You'd need to add a SSD, so that's a solid state disk. So that's slightly different from an HDD. And you would obviously need to actually upgrade to Windows 11, which fortunately Microsoft are offering free. So the total upgrade cost for that is approximately 105 to 190, but that's compared to buying a new machine, which is, let's say, around 1,000. By upgrading it, the PC actually is going to be available, which means that it's going to be a better investment than buying a brand new machine. Bear in mind, depending on your skill set, this doesn't take into account actually upgrading it. So you might need to factor in additional money to take it into a store to get it upgraded, which I haven't included here. Scenario two, when replacement is just not going to be a viable option. So, this first off is a laptop. Some laptops will let you upgrade the basics, for example, increasing the RAM, but most of the time, a laptop is not really upgradable in terms of its hardware. So, this example is a laptop that's over 6 years old. The RAM can't be upgraded. The processor is too old for Windows 11's requirements. It's not got a compatible motherboard. You've been using it and it shows. So it's got failing battery. The keyboard isn't as easy to see anymore. And you've got limited storage options to expand. In this case, even if upgrades were technically possible, which they aren't, the hardware, it doesn't meet the minimum Windows 11 requirements. You've got too much that is nearing its end of life and would have to be upgraded anyway. Even if you installed Windows 11, it's going to be slow, and who's got time for that? The cost of somebody actually upgrading it, and you would need to take it in, unless this is what you already know, is going to be potentially quite a lot. So, in that respect, buying a new laptop, which could be 400 to 600, would be a better cost because you'd have to upgrade everything anyway. And that means you're going to get 5+ years of use out of this new device. My final thoughts for you, consider the age of your device. Is it actually worth upgrading? And that's even if the computer does match the minimum requirements for Windows 11. You have to work within your budget. And remember, that's not just upgrading the hardware, but that's getting it installed. Whichever route you choose to go, please make sure that you back up your files so that if the worst case happens, you've still got all your data. And an additional tip, which most people don't think about, the applications that are on your computer, the ones that you use regularly. So these are the ones that are installed, not the ones that are web-based. Do you still have that license information? Let's be honest, you may have bought them quite a few years ago. Do you still have that information? Can you get to it? Can you re-download it? Is there a new version that will run with Windows 11? Because the current one on Windows 10 might not. So consider all of that before you upgrade. And that's again, no matter if you're actually upgrading just Windows, your operating system, or if you are actually spending out some additional money, either to upgrade the hardware or you are buying a new computer. If you found this video useful, then please do click that like button. It really does help the channel. And if you'd like to be notified as new videos become available in the future, they are every week, then please subscribe to the channel and click that notification bell to be told as the videos are available. That's all for now.